Let's get into today's top stories. And three people have been arrested after the bodies of 46 migrants were found inside a semi-trailer in Texas. 16 other people, including four children, were found alive. They've been taken to hospital suffering heat stroke and heat exhaustion. San Antonio authorities were alerted to the tragedy after a worker in a nearby building heard a cry for help.
The patients that we saw were hot to the touch. No signs of water in the vehicle.
This is nothing short of a horrific human tragedy.
A new CEDA report has laid bare the growing crisis within Australia's aged care system. The data indicates the sector is headed towards a worst-case scenario with a staffing shortfall of 35,000 workers. That number has doubled in less than a year because of poor conditions and low migration.
The 35,000 will get us to around that kind of basic care quality. If we want to actually get kind of international best practice standards, we need something like at least an extra 8,000 on top of that.
And a great start at Wimbledon for Aussie Thanasi Kokkinakis, who's making his seventh appearance at the All England Club. But he won his first match ever to set up at that event, I should say, to set up a huge second round clash with Novak Djokovic. Novak beat South Korea's Sun Woo-kwon in four sets to advance. He broke a record as well for like the highest number of wins at Grand Slams by a male athlete. So it seems quite fitting, yeah, that Thanasi Kokkinakis not just his first at Wimbledon on the same day.
One versus a million.
One versus a million, and it is likely that Novak Djokovic is probably going to cruise on through to the finals.
Is there a chance, though, Wimbledon introduces a vaccine mandate before round two?
No. Interestingly, though, he has already been grilled whether or not he would take the jab ahead of the US Open again because he was like, I've done everything in my power. There's nothing more I can do. And someone was like, you could get vaccinated. And he was like, no. So, yeah, that's still happening. But also the Special Ks are going to be at Wimbledon again too. So Thanasi Kokkinakis through the second round of the singles, but he will be playing with Nick Kyrgios again as well.
How has he not won a match until now?
I know.
How is it possible? I would have thought he would have.
It just goes to show how difficult, though, it is, right? Like, we take it for granted because we talk about Novak Djokovic, Roger Federer, Rafael Nadal, Serena Williams. Like, they make it look so easy. Yeah. And then, you know, he's this guy.
I've never won at Wimbledon.
Yeah. No, I can't imagine.
It's a sad day for you that finally he's pulled past you.
Yeah, I know. Always had that on Thanasi.
It's not done yet.
No, that's true.
No, there's still a bit of life in the old kid yet.
All right. The former police officer who shot dead Australian woman Justine Ruzcek-Dumond in Minneapolis in 2017 has been released from prison. Mohammed Noor has been paroled after being handed a lighter sentence for manslaughter when his murder conviction was overturned. He spent just over 3 years behind bars.
35 newly elected MPs have descended on Canberra for what's known as poly school. They get 2 days of orientation to learn the ropes and hallways of Parliament House. Member for North Sydney, Kylie Tink, says the reality of the job is now sinking in.
It was a moment this morning when I first pushed the intercom and explained who I was, and the security guard actually responded, "Welcome to Parliament House, Miss Tink." And I think as I pushed that gate, it was, this is really happening.
And 6 out of 10 Americans reckon they have what it takes to be an action movie star. The survey has found they completely believe they could match the likes of The Rock or Chris Hemsworth. But the claim does come with a caveat. They would need the right training and resources to become a Hollywood star. Just sensible.
Some of these same people also thought Donald Trump would be a good president. So, you know, you've got to take it with a grain of salt.
And some people believe he was a superhero. Yeah, no, they don't always wear capes. No. I just think I could be a different kind of superhero.
Yes. What's the language superhero?
Oh, no, I haven't devised that yet, but it will involve sitting on a couch and yelling at children. Why not?
It's very relatable superhero.
Mint slices on a Friday night.
Yeah.
To be fair, good. It's probably harder than a lot of the stunts, I've got to say.
Well, I think, like a lot of people, you know, you watch those movies and you think, oh, I could do that. Just the same way when Oprah Winfrey lost all that weight, everyone was like, I could do that if I had a private chef and a trainer. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? And possibly we couldn't.
Why did everyone talk like that for a few years? What was that about?
It was a very good Carrie accent, actually. You really...